actually, the most important thing I have to do is to finish the book.
What?
The book. This one. This book. The most important. You know, I there are a lot of people, a lot of students frustrated doing mathematics. I tried. This is the best I can do. Yes. But occupied a lot of time. However, the most difficult part is not finish it. How to publish it? I will tell you. Maybe I will meet the most difficult part now.
Yes.
how to realize it? Okay. So, in the very beginning, I have mentioned Hamiltonian cycle. If I were a PhD student, I would not do Hamiltonian cycle. Definitely. No way to go. But after I travel, each cycle, there are still a lot of things to do. So now I give you one more. Actually, maybe I can do more or something like that. I don't know. Yeah. This is called mutually independent Hamiltonian path and mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle. So the story is the following. This is my house, and maybe department here, and we are going to somewhere. I ask my students to go there. One student traverse the Hamiltonian cycle, the Hamiltonian path, traverse. Here to here, the other traverse in this direction. Not very curious, but if I arrange it again, I check every time they are in different places. Every time step, they are in different places. See? Do you want to check more? No. Step one, this one here. Step two, step one, then here, then go there, and here, then maybe here, right? Then here, then here. No. Every step, they are in different places. What's the application of the game? The application, I think, we are going to have a travel plan to maybe from here to here. The travel agency, you have a two tour, then you can arrange one tour here and the other tour here. Because you know you cannot go both in the same time because the hotel the I think each hotel has at most maybe 100 people. You suppose 200 people go there, then it's crowded, right? So you can separate the case and arrange more, right? Yeah, that's the application. I think you have a lot of application on that. Yeah. Maybe for this one, this graph, maybe not that clear. Maybe begin here, ending here. You try to arrange, reallocate. Maybe begin here, ending here. You still have the same situation happen. The same cases happen. Any two vertices, for any two vertices, you have such beautiful situation. I know, it's so beautiful. So that's the beautiful. Yeah, I think this beautiful result. This is called mutually independent Hamiltonian path. Okay? Okay. I hope later, then I will discuss later. So you may ask, how about the mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle? Right? I think I have mentioned this graph. I call it Earth graph. Really, yeah. I have shown you before. I think I've shown you before. You see, I call this graph ice graph because it's closely related. You open your eyes larger and larger. I like such graph for some reason. You can study polar coordinate on this graph, right? It's something like that. Right? And so for this reason, you can cover maybe the north hemisphere of the Earth. And you can also cover the south hemisphere. Then, for this graph, this is Earth. It's really Earth graph, so this is Earth graph. In Christmas, we are going to sing a song to visit every room, Christmas song, right? Sing Christmas song to every house, and however, we have a team in our home, old man, old woman, and the children. So everybody go with me, then we sing three songs in every family. It will take a long time. So we arrange in a different way. Yeah. The first one, old man, go this way. Try to find a Hamiltonian cycle. The first one, go Hamiltonian cycle like this way. The female chorus, they sing the Hamiltonian cycle in this way. In this way. And the children in another way. Then I arrange it as I think. Each time, each different slide, different slot, we are in different places. Each different slot, we are in different places. So, maybe it's the problem is we begin with vertex one. So we change. Begin with vertex 22. So begin with vertex 22. Then we still have a situation like that. Okay? You will begin with this vertex 21. Again, we still have this case. However, if you look at the symmetry of this graph, when I talk about when I talk about vertex 1, then I think the same thing is 11, 12, 24, 23, and 22. This I have already done, right? I have already done. If I do, I talk about, I mean, if I begin with vertex one, then I 1, 4, 7, and 13, 16, 19. If I talk about 22, then 22, 23, 24, 10, 11, 12. If I talk about 21, then 20, 2, 3, 9, 8, 15, 14. So every vertex have the same story. Right? Every vertex has the same story. No problem. So that is called mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles. Okay? It is very close to a very beautiful mathematics it's very close. You already know. No, now. Let me show you the story. What is the story? If you come up with the complete graph, it is a Latin square. It's a generalization of Latin square. Or you can say another variation of Sudoku. Right? So it's an old story. You can also discuss. I didn't write in the paper, but you can, if you start with this point of view, this is a Latin square, then you have a mutually independent Latin square stuff. Then you can still have mutually independent something like that. So it is not old. It is old, really old. Yeah. If you from different point of view, yeah. So you know the definition. So for the baby, yeah. Now it's for the baby stuff. You know that this is the puzzle, but the student can play with. So. Every cubic, two mutually independent Hamiltonian paths, graph, is 1/8 for tolerant, is 1 vertex for tolerant Hamiltonian. How to prove it? Okay, here's a graph. You pick anyone, 40, say 16, 20. So you begin with begin with 16 and you find 16 to 17, you find two mutually independent Hamiltonian paths. You find it. Then with this one, 8, 16, 7, what do you get? A 4-3 Hamiltonian cycle for this one, 20, 16, 20 is 40. Is that a proof? It is proof, right? Okay? So maybe the student prove just to draw the picture, then give them zero graded. I don't know, but it's really proof, yeah. Suppose a vertex 4. Suppose a vertex is 40. I begin with 1 to 17 to find the two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles. Then, you see the result. I delete the vertex 1 and get 7, 16, 17, then I got a fourth free Hamiltonian cycle. And that is my proof. I think it's quite reasonable for young men to understand what I'm talking about. So, now I'm begin with the comparison. I have several talk about the global system, 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian, something. So this one, this graph, the graph is Hamiltonian connected, 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian and global system. However, this graph, is not two mutually independent Hamiltonian. How to prove it? The proof is you begin with this, end with this, then go this way and go this way, and you begin everything. You see, begin here, and you can, let me see. Can you figure it out? I think it's quite reasonable. The next step is one here. The next step. If you go this way, this way, this way, then you will hit here. So if you go this way and this way, later you will matched. So this one is not the two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle. And this one, this is two independent Hamiltonian connected. So this Hamiltonian connected, and this is 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian, because I had told you every two independent Hamiltonian is one-four tolerant Hamiltonian connected. And this one is not globally switched star. Can you prove it? It is not globally switched star, because I had told you. If this one is globally switched star, you shrink all the three cycle, you will get a graph. Maybe you will get this graph. This graph is K33. It's a bipartite graph. You cannot do. Okay. So. And this graph is Hamiltonian connected. This graph is, I have already proved, I think in the previous paper, previous slide, I talked, this is 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. It is neither Hamiltonian connected nor globally switched. So it is 1-4 but not global. Don't remember. Oh, it does. Okay, yeah, it is not global switched star, so the larger one is not global switched star. The crucial thing is this graph is not two mutually independent Hamiltonian connected. It is Hamiltonian connected, but it is not two mutually independent Hamiltonian connected. Two mutually independent Hamiltonian connected. How to prove this one, this graph is not two mutually independent Hamiltonian connected? I can only show that any Hamiltonian path from x to y Z must be the second vertex. Z must be the second vertex. Because once you go out, then you will hit. So to prove this, in other words, you delete this edge, you don't have any Hamiltonian pass. You delete this edge, you don't have any Hamiltonian pass, right? So the remaining part to show this fact is Greenberg condition. Greenberg condition to prove it, standard technique. So, and then I have something like that. It's never published. I don't know any it's deserved published or not. When we talk about Hamiltonian connected, it may be 1, 0. It's not Hamiltonian connected, or Hamiltonian connected, or two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle. Two independent Hamiltonian connected. When I talk about three independent Hamiltonian cycle, so it can be 1, 2, 3. There are a lot of combination, right? 3 by 3 should be 9. So we think about the possibility of any combination of these two. Okay? Really, yeah. So for this graph, this is a cubic graph. They are mutually dependent Hamiltonian cycle being any vertices. The graph is not Hamiltonian connected. It is Hamiltonian connected, but we cannot find two mutually independent Hamiltonian paths. It is not two. Okay. For this graph, this is I believe this is the pancake graph. I have told you. Bill Gates has some paper, one paper, on the pancake graph. For this graph, there are three mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles. This is not pancake. This is not pancake. Maybe this may be star graph. This is not pancake graph. So this graph is not Hamiltonian connected between some pair of vertices. I think this is star graph. For this graph, we can only find two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles. There are two mutually independent Hamiltonian paths between any two vertices. I mean this graph. I think it may be wrong. This one is cubic Hamiltonian graph. There are three mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles and no two mutually independent Hamiltonian paths. And 34 is this graph. Cubic Hamiltonian graph, they are mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle between any vertex, and no two independent Hamiltonian paths. And this graph is cubic graph. There are three mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle, not Hamiltonian connected. This one is not Hamiltonian connected because there is no Hamiltonian path from this one to this one. They have three mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles, and there are two mutually independent Hamiltonian paths between any two vertices. And this graph is you have two mutually two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles, but only one Hamiltonian, we cannot find the one Hamiltonian connected.
one independent Hamiltonian connected. And only two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycles. The graph is not Hamiltonian connected. This one is not Hamiltonian connected. And we have there is no two, just that is mean one independent Hamiltonian cycle and Hamiltonian connected, but no two. Hamiltonian graph, no two independent Hamiltonian cycle, so it means one independent Hamiltonian and not Hamiltonian connected. There is only one is missing, is can you find one, two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle with two, there is no two mutually independent Hamiltonian cycle that begins, and there are two mutually independent Hamiltonian paths between any two vertices. And I wonder, such graph exists. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. So that's as I mentioned before, you should already know the story of the really background of that story. This is Latin square. Yeah, original and. So the open problem should be this one. Can you find one? You know, there are, at the very beginning, for example, hypo-Hamiltonian graph is, or there are something like called SNARK. They are trying to, a lot of people try to find several graphs with several spatial properties, the existence of such graph. So is such graph exist? I don't know. But this is really the old story, the old story. And can you? I mean, show you. There are a lot of things can be done on Hamiltonian. So maybe I show you one more. So maybe this is not in my in this original. I tried to add this chapter, but I don't want to. The problem is once you look at the story, Tom and Jerry, can you find two independent Hamiltonian cycles spanning all the vertices? Can you find two independent Hamiltonian cycles? Because they are going to fight with each other. So there are a lot of Hamiltonian. So now it's one Hamiltonian to two Hamiltonian stuff. There are a lot of stuff that can be done. Not Hamiltonian, not two disjoint Hamiltonian cycle spanning the whole vertices. But there are a lot of works can be done. But any question? Maybe too fast.
Well,
yeah.
Has it been asked questions? That is sense. It is my honor to give you a certificate of participation for giving this course of lectures. And now I think that we have another view of Hamiltonian and Euler cycles. Thank you very much. And it is a small present.
Thank you.
From Novosibirsk State University. Okay, let us then speak again. Yeah.
Professor Hsu. Could you please show the name of your book one more time on camera?
So. The name of the book?
Yeah.
I really do not know whether it will be published or not, but maybe. Is that? I don't know. maybe. Finger mathematic, study mathematics without with finger, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Who is the